This is a good distance. Oh, okay, that's really loud.
We obviously a fantastic victory over, you know, a legend of the sport that's been around forever. Give me an idea what the kind of the feeling is for you right now.
You know, first and foremost, I want to thank God for the opportunity to fight in the UFC. One, thank you to Dana White for picking me the Contender Series, the UFC itself, and I want to thank Matt Brown. Fighting him and getting a win over him is amazing. I mean, this is my second fight in the UFC, and I got an opportunity to step in with a legend, like a true, like, gangster in the division, and it was awesome. It literally is turning into a scrap. Like, I wanted to stay disciplined. I mean, I don't know what happened. We just got in there, and I was just like, let's just do it. And then, you know, everything turned up well for me. So, again, thank God. And thank you to my team, MMA Masters, Cesar Serhey, Round 5, all the guys back home, Kevin Gleason, Greg Choplin, everybody back at Round 5, everybody in South Florida, Davey, Carl Ranieri, Kevin Gleason, again, if I mentioned you, I'm sorry. Wagner, the list goes on. Coach Morgan, all that.
I was going to ask you what was going through your mind, because I can't imagine that the game plan was to, like, hey, let's just go in there and brawl with Matt Brown and see what happens. So it turns into a brawl. Is anything going through your head? What are you thinking?
No, I mean, like, we got in there, I landed a few things, and all of a sudden I was like, I don't know, I just saw something and I went for it. And obviously, he got me before I got him. And, you know, it turned into a scrap. And, you know, I'm playing for it, but, it, you know, it just turned that way. And I felt like I got it to him first, and I ended up getting to him later on. In the second round.
Yeah, you mentioned getting tagged. Can you tell, I mean, how hurt were you? Was it a struggle?
You know, everybody says, like, oh, they didn't get hurt or anything like that. I know I got hit with something, you know, definitely. Obviously, like, I'm not going to sit here and be like, that was nothing. Like, you can look at the replay, man. It was definitely something. But, you know, it hurt, but it wasn't anything I felt like I couldn't recover from, you know, just kind of a quick flash, you know, and then I was like, oh shit, I'm in trouble, you know, and then I was able to find my feet again and then keep going.
Yeah. What was the key? I mean, quick finish in the second round, were there any adjustments made?
I feel like I got the timing better. I got, you know, I kind of saw his entry and was able to capitalize on the counter.
Nice. Last thing for me, I mean, you get a win this early in your career over a name like that. Where do you go from here? What's next?
Whatever the UFC has next for me. You know, I we haven't said no. You know, we just take the fights, you know. And, I got a great team behind me. Again, all the guys at MMA Masters, my coach, Cesar Square. I got, like, a couple of coaches, Cesar Carnero, Daniel Valverde, Cesar Serhey. I mean, they believe in me no matter what. And I believe in them, so we're ready to go. And they support me and they train me, you know, and I feel like we can go and take on anybody, so.
Miguel, right here.
Yes.
Matt Brown had obviously been fighting for about 10 years before you even made your professional debut, to the point where when he got you against the cage, all of us in the back were like, here come the elbows that we've seen a million times. So how much of Matt Brown had you watched even before you were matched up?
Oh, man. I think he was on the Ultimate Fighter 7. And I remember watching the first Ultimate Fighter when I was 12. And I was like, man, I want to do that. I mean, I've said this before, but I saw that and I was like, oh, you know, I don't know what this is, but I want to get into it, you know? Like, and I remember watching every Ultimate Fighter after that and then seeing him and how tough he was even back then, saying how much of a badass he was. And when I first got the name, again, me and my team were like, is there another Matt Brown in the division we don't know about, you know, there too? And it turned out to be him, and it was just like a, you know, it was an honor. Like, it was like, if the UFC thinks that highly of me, then let's do it, you know?
Were there any moments in there, like after you said you had watched him, that felt a little surreal when you would see these?
Immediately, dude. I'd seen his face. Just seeing it, I was like, oh, that's Matt Brown. That's really Matt Brown, you know. And it was just a crazy thing. As soon as we kind of squared it, I'm like, you know, it sounds weird, but, like, you know, you kind of dream of these moments, you know, like, and then it was there. And it was just a crazy feeling, you know, to, like, get to punch him in the face and him punch me in the face. You know, it's in a way a dream come true, you know.
Thank you.
Schmo, what's up, man? I like the suit. No questions? All right, no, that's cool. Don't worry about it. All right.